we're gonna make rigatoni a la vodka sauce. And Katrina, parla italiano molto bene, so we're gonna leave all the pronunciation to her. We're gonna use Parmesano tomatoes, vodka, Parmigiano Reggiano, shallots, and garlic, of course. Okay, so we're gonna start by our water is boiling. I'm gonna salt the water.
I'm gonna salt the water.
And bring it back to a boil. Add our rigatoni. Once it comes back to a boil again, you stir. That's how our pasta is gonna get stuck. Do not add oil to the pasta, or else the sauce won't get stuck to the pasta, so it's not good. Okay, stop. Okay, so add a little bit of olive oil to get it started, and we're gonna render all this bacon. We're gonna render the fat. I'm gonna scoop it out, and then we're gonna start our sauce. We're just gonna leave a little bit of bacon fat in there so we can start our sauce.
Flavor.
And we want to wait until they're caramelized. And we use 2 shallots and 2 cloves of garlic. And now we pour our Parmesano tomatoes and I squeeze them to make like a little sauce. And I usually use local organic, but since we're going authentic today, we're using Parmesano tomatoes. And Katrina's ready for this, so let's add our sauce. Wait, maybe like 10 minutes to our sauce is ready. For our bacon.
So crispy and yummy.
Okay. We have absolute vodka. And we're gonna add 1/2 cup. And you want to pour it into a cup, because if I pour it from the bottle, it can light up and light up my whole thing. I'm going to turn it off completely before I add the vodka, because I don't want it to light up. I usually do, but I don't want to do it for the purposes. And I'm going to try it, see where we're at, and it needs a little bit of more vodka.
How do you tell if you need more vodka?
You taste it. You want to try it? Does it need more vodka?
Pretty flavorful.
Yeah, you can taste the vodka. Okay, so we're gonna let the alcohol and the vodka evaporate a little bit. Then we're gonna add our cream. And we're gonna use just 1/2 cup of cream. And this is gonna turn it into a cream sauce.
Let me see if it's evaporated yet.
Let's pretend I use a new spoon.
A little longer.
There goes our cream.
And there's our sauce. I waited maybe 5 minutes. And our sauce is ready. I'm going to Parmigiano Reggiano. Bind it and make it even more thick. And I'm gonna add my pasta. And I don't drain it in the drain because I want some of that pasta water, because the starches from the pasta will thicken our sauce. And we're finished cooking the pasta and the sauce. Also, I like rigatoni because it, those little ridges hold on to the sauce. But if you like any other pasta, feel free to use whatever you like or whatever you can find. We were looking for another one today, but we couldn't find it. What were we looking for, Katrina?
Lacio panodini penne. The a really fat penne.
I love that one. Or you can also use penne. Penne's great, and it's easy to find.
So,
okay, our pasta's ready.
Dish. It looks amazing!
And Katrina's gonna top it with even more Parmesan Reggiano. There you go, Katrina! Mm-hmm. Oh, you can start reading them.